Day two at the Silos.
Silos Marketplace. We're going for the food trucks today. Magnolia Silos Marketplace. We're going for the food trucks today. And it was like so much to choose from. We decided on the Asian at the club sandwich place. They didn't have club sandwiches, but they had some Asian bowls.
Let me know one protein, I can build a bowl for you that tastes pretty good as well. And we do make everything to order, so if you don't like onions on there, just say, hey, no onions or something. We've been here for about a year, 2 years? 2 years now, and Magnolia's been great. Before this, we were kind of going around Waco, finding spots to hook up and everything. But since we've been here, business has been steady. Obviously, people coming in, they want to eat, so we'll hear from them.
How you be doing? Welcome to the Silos of Magnolia.
What's going on, boss?
Smells heavenly. I smell spicy. I smell meaty, pork, chicken, mayonnaise. I am in heaven right now. It smells awesome. I smell pickled, a tart smell. I smell spicy. It feels warm in my hand. I see rice and lots of vegetables, cilantro, and soy. It's a nice cool day, and this is nice hot pork, and it's an Asian mixture, rice down there, that lots of cilantro and creamy and rice and pork. My first big bite. The mixture together, the cilantro mayonnaise is spicy and warm and creamy. Something's got a little after bite spice to it, but the rice cuts it, something real smoky. I think it's the pork. I mean the beef is the chicken. The chicken is very smoky. It's a real heavy smoky flavor. Pork. The pork was a little spicy pork in it. I said it was chicken, but it was actually pork. There's something smoky in here. I don't know what it is. There's something very smoky in here. And the cilantro is very crisp. And the rice cuts it. And it's, There's a little bit of sweetness to something. The sriracha is spicy. Very Asian.
Verdict?
It's very good. The creaminess, the coolness. I like it a lot. It's number two in Waco food trucks. And the number one one's not here, is what they said. And I believe it's number one here so far, because this is the first one we're getting. Try it. They had a health food truck with smoothies. It was Halloween. They had a vampire drink, and it was so out of this world.
And it did make you feel good.
It did. It was very energizing.
Vitamin rich.
Vitamin rich. I felt healthy.
It's blood orange, apple, and beets, which is for our Halloween. It's our juice of the month. It's called vampire drink. What everybody
it's
really
a
likes.
Good variety. Very
and everybody's
variety.
Local, and we all started from the ground up. We all, most of us, have started like a farmer's market type thing.
Oh, yeah. So do you have a restaurant on the side, or?
That's the thing. Like, most of us start, ours opens in January, and I know Milo has one opening soon. I know Club Sandwich is working on, so this is kind of our next step from the farmer's market here, and then we'll step up to the next one.
Yeah. Beets, apples, blood oranges. It's a vampire drink. It's tart. You can hear it. Taste the tartness. It's not too tart because it's got a counterbalance of the very sweet, very fresh taste. And they fresh squeeze it every morning. You can really taste the orange juice. And you can slightly taste the carrots too. So it's got a nice balance. Very nice balance. Very refreshing.
Vitamin rich.
Vitamin rich. I felt healthy.
Hot dogs. Get your hot dogs.
The hot dog place. It was a lot of fun at the dog house.
They were funny too. Nice people.
Very nice. Everybody there was so nice and friendly.
It was like the perfect sort of ballpark dog.
Kind of a classic.
James and Kim.
Or Kim and James. I love your Mickey Mouse.
Thank you. My little girl had the ears, so I had everything else at home.
You smell of the onions, toasted bread, and hot dog. This is the hot dog place. I'm gonna take a huge bite here. Sauerkraut. A little bitterness in the sauerkraut. Hot dog's very meaty, and the onions are cool and crisp. And it's got a good smoky flavor to it. I brown the toast so the bun is nice and warm. It is. The only thing could have been better if I go get some ketchup and put on it right now.
Oh boy, here we go. Dessert time.
This was a classic French crepe place. They actually have the little wheel that they make it on, and they had the batter, and it was cool and creamy and decadent.
We've been excited to come try your crepes. We came by yesterday, and we got here too late, so we had all night to think about it. I think I decided the blackberry jam and cream cheese.
Awesome. Did you like whipped cream and powdered sugar?
Well, yeah. That's the best part. You get, oh my gosh, you go home smelling like crepes, huh? That's gotta be good.
The crepe itself was just made so it was warm, and then they had the cool, creamy filling that was just...
Yeah, that was a surprise. A real explosion of flavors in your mouth.
Explosion of yum.
That's right. I remember the expression on your face when you took the first bite. You were like, oh my gosh.
It was probably one of my favorite things there.
Awesome. Have a great one.
Thanks. Crepes. I can't smell the whipped cream yet, but I smell the crepe. It smells like vanilla-y, and it smells sweet and vanilla-y. I taste cream cheese. The crepe tastes buttery and light. And the powdered sugar is sweet, but the cream cheese is not overly sweet, very, it's almost savory sweet. Is it strawberries? Strawberries or, you really get a taste of Nutella. The Nutella, it's got this nutty taste, but it's just like an underlying nutty taste to it. You really, it's so understated. It's like a pillow, you eat a pillow in your mouth. So good, so good. It's like eating a unicorn. So much fun here. They have lights, they have music. It's a cool day, and it's you have the old silos with the rest on them, but they're painted and pretty. They're peeling paint, but it's a very pretty, awesome place. And the shopping is very not stressful at all. Everything's got this old touch to it. It's kind of like going back in time in some ways. It has a relaxed feeling, a relaxed, fun feeling, and there's all these different episodes to it, because you got the shopping areas, and you got the garden area, and you've got the food area. So, I mean, you can't go wrong here. You got food, you got shopping, and you got the gardens. And it's just, every inch of it is beautiful. Every inch is decorated, and it's just, you just walk around just looking. It's like you can just stay here for days or hours and not even realize that you've been here. It's a lot of fun. And the food is good. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up, share, and hit subscribe.
And we're going to go back tomorrow so we can see a little bit of what the shopping is inside. And then we're going to stay in Waco and hit one more place. We're going to hit a restaurant in the downtown area as well.
Yep, we're moving out of the Magnolia area out into Waco tomorrow.
Who knew it would take so much time to cover the town of Waco?
There's a lot there.
Definitely a place that you should go and visit.
Yes, I loved it.